Welcome back, my friends. My name's Dylan. I just put a PhD in physics on hold to create some fun things. One of those things, my AI project, AIMyInterior.com, is out now, and you can use it for free. You don't need a credit card. Just take a picture of your room, you upload it to my site, and you can turn it into any interior design style in literally 30 seconds. So come renovate your whole house. Come have some fun. AI My Cars is also about to drop. Asteroid impact comparison. Let's do it. So, of course, we'll talk about that big asteroid that wiped out the dinosaurs. You know, technically, it was the highest ratio of killing birds to one stone in Earth's history. Fun little fact. Okay, thank you. In this video, we use Hiroshima and Zaboma as the unit of measure for destructive power. That's pretty cool, especially after the videos we've just been making. So we're pausing the nuclear, we're pausing the Oppenheimer celebration week for these last two, and then we'll get back to, you know, a couple more. Size 20 meters, similar to, I can't pronounce that. Frequency, once in every 70 years, I see. Energy, airburst, 18 heroes, explosion height, 21 kilometers. Wow, this is a great video. Next impact, 50 meters, that's pretty big. Once every 900 years, 388 heroes, 7.5 kilometers. We can make a bomb that big easily. Packed area, New York City. There's plenty of hydrogen bombs with twice this yield. Damn, that did some damage. So that one made it to the ground. Tunguska. Yeah, the Tunguska event is a pretty cool event. One every 4,500 years, is that correct? How many heroes? 208. So NASA actually just told everyone a couple weeks ago to not make any plans on Valentine's Day 2046 because a newly discovered asteroid might just hit us. Don't worry though, it's like one in, I think, 560 chance that it does. So yeah, don't worry about it. It's 50 meters, by the way. So that's pretty big, right? 1 kilometer is a world killer, planet killer. But I mean, just keep in mind, 23 years is a lot of time for it to change its course and increase the chances of it hitting us. Also keep in mind, guys, this depends on how fast these things are moving. Obviously, like, that is one of the major components here. It doesn't just matter how big it is, it matters how fast it's moving. I wasn't paying too much attention at the start. Did they say that every asteroid is moving at the same speed? Because their velocity is going to be really important for how much energy is going to be, you know, go boom. All right, that's entirely a major component here. And on average, an asteroid's traveling at about 17 kilometers every second. That's fucking fast. So, I mean, did I miss it? Where are we at? 213. No. I guess they're just taking the average of this one that would happen every. Okay, so that must be what they're doing. Any. Boom. We're getting craters now. You wonder why the craters are always round like this and they're not like, you know, displaced and there's like kind of slides, right? You'd expect an oval. It's because when they hit the ground, they just explode because there's more energy. There's more kinetic energy than the chemical energy holding it together. So when it hits something, it'll go pow, kind of like when you throw a snowball at a wall, right? There's not much chemical energy and stuff holding it together. When you throw, it's got more kinetic energy. And so that energy has to go somewhere and it goes bang. And a snowball explodes. And if you throw a snowball at the wall in front of you, it'll leave a round imprint. You throw a snowball at the wall on an angle, it still leaves a round imprint because it explodes. That's why all the craters on the moon are round. You never thought about that? so many craters on the moon, they're all fucking around. It's like, what the hell is going on? Why aren't they on ovals? And for a long time, scientists thought they were these craters were actually from volcanic activity. But no, we then saw Shoemaker-Levy hit Jupiter's atmosphere and just explode. And we're like, what's going on there? We realized, all right, this makes a bit more sense. And just think about how old the moon is. We've never seen anything like hit it and go boom. But actually we have. There was, a couple priests way back, like 1,000 years ago, and they documented it in their notebook or something. They didn't want to tell anyone because they were kind of scared them. But this one priest apparently saw an explosion on the moon and thought, you know, the end of times is nigh. Mm-hmm. 370 meters. Apophis. All right, so Neil deGrasse Tyson has sounded the alarm on this one for a fair while because it is due to come back around in the 2030s at some point. I think it's like 2038, 2039 or something. It's not going to hit us. There's a very low chance it's going to hit us. Don't worry. But anyway, so this happens once every 97,000 years. 51 Tsar bombs. Okay, so that's a lot of energy because one Tsar bomb is about 50 megatons TNT. So that's 2,500 megatons TNT. That's a lot of TNT. I want to sing the AC/DC song, DNT, but we'll get copyrighted, so I can't. Aussie legend. Okay, that's not good. Get out of here, fly. Just an FYI, they only need to be over a kilometer to be considered a planet killer. And if you didn't know, just last year, end of last year, we discovered one of these bastards just floating around. So it's in the top, I think it's 1.1 kilometers, about that. And, you know, it's in the top 5% of... you know, sizes we've discovered of these things. And if it hit the planet, it would not be good. It would blow up so much pollutants into the atmosphere that, you know, there'd be mass extinction events, and it would be horrific, and there'd be less sunlight getting down to the Earth's surface and all sorts of wonderful things. Earth would cool significantly. Currently, it's crossing our path, though, when we're on the opposite side of the sun. But over time, this thing is going to start to cross our orbit closer to where we are, and it could be a problem in some centuries, but I'm sure we'll be able to deal with it. That's not good at all. All right, let's hope this ain't gonna happen anytime soon. I think the destruction would actually be significantly worse. Armageddon. Fantastic movie. So many just silly things in it that, you know, just break science. Crater 14 kilometers. Like when they send these drillers, these oil drillers to the moon to drill, not the moon, sorry, to this fucking asteroid, to drill down in the asteroid and put a big bomb in there. And so they think it's going to be easier to train the drillers to be astronauts than to train astronauts to drill a hole. And then they're up there in space in these shuttles flying around as if there's fucking air. And they're going like... psh, psh. It's pretty funny. Makes for a great movie. It's a great movie, all right. Bruce Willis, Ben Affleck. That song that I also can't sing. Once every 500 million years, we're up to the Great Bird Killer. Yep, 65 million years ago. And we're due again. So, we also recently discovered, guys, if you didn't see, that it looks like it had a little twin, had a buddy. It looks like there was two right? And one closely followed the impact of this thing, which is really interesting. And then let's see how they visualize this, because I don't think that... ...30,000 near-Earth objects now, and that's rising. Like, we've discovered most of those in the last decade. Awesome. That's so cool. So, there's some current hypotheses suggesting that before this thing even hit the surface, that it might have actually, to some degree, bubbled the crust, to the point where, you know, the magma was already rising up at the crust before it even hit, which is just insane. And if you see here, right, like, there's no sort of shock wave that's sent out. Wait, has it hit already? No, good, they did. See how there's a shock wave that spread out? I missed that. Ready? It goes... It hasn't even hit the ground yet. This is good stuff. And it might have been more severe at the surface before it hit. Yeah, that actually showed that there was a mega tsunami, possibly just set on its way from the dino-killing asteroid, and a simulation actually showed that it hit Australia. Next impact. All right, 20 kilometers. How many heroes? It's our bombs, all right. I don't watch the news, don't worry. I mean, like, science news. Literally, end of Feb, we just found this asteroid that's going to pass in between Earth and the Moon, and they're calling it a once-in-a-decade event. But if you look at astronomy news, we constantly find asteroids, and we only just saw this thing. That's the whole point, right? We constantly do this, where it's like, hey, there goes something again, and we, you know, discover it after it's gone by, and it, like, you know, doesn't... It's not that far away, right? It's like between Earth and the Moon, sometimes just beyond the Moon. Moon's only 350,000 kilometers away, all right? And we only just discover these things time after time. So I don't know, you know, are we going to get unlucky soon and something slams us? Potentially. I don't think we'll miss anything big enough to sort of do, you know, end civilization. But I think there'll be events like the Tunguska event again, maybe even soon. Very likely it'll just hit the ocean, though, because, you know, this place is mostly water. Hundred kilometers. All right, this is a world killer, right? Once every 4 billion years. All right, it's important to say here as well, I've said in other videos, that all of these things, right, if you go back to the early, you know, early time in Earth's early history, you know, during the heavy bombardment and late bombardment, all these things, right? There was way more debris. We got hit so much more often, all the time. There were dino-killing asteroids hitting us every, I think it was every 15 million years. Or, no, was it every 15,000 years? Like, just getting smashed, all right? So, thousands of R-bombs. Hang on a second. Impact energy, wasn't the last one 8,700,000 R bombs? What's going on? Let me check. 450. Yeah, what the hell? Oh, M. So I think they're meaning mega R bombs? 1,000 times a million R bombs? Sorry, every 4 billion years. 9,000 billion R bombs. Again, keep in mind, guys, you get what I'm saying? Like, it's so this one, actually, there's some interesting stuff behind this, because if you've heard of the early impact hypothesis, this is what this is referring to, all right? In Earth's early history, there's a hypothesis that Earth was hit by a Mars-sized moon or planet, right? And it just went bang. And that resulted in the moon. The moon was what was left. That's one of... It's actually the leading theory hypothesis for how the moon was formed. And if you're wondering how the hell we know this, right? There's actually some evidence if you go look at the moon. We know that it was molten down, you know, for some reason at this sort of time. And to do that, it would require enough energy, you know, the similar amount of energy that would be sort of created if that event, what we just said, happened. So that's why we suspect it didn't happen. I love the music for this one. It's a big boy. Kaboom! Yeah, that ain't good. Roast of us. Awesome video. Really good video. But there's another thing. Now, you might think, oh, asteroids, you know, they're not that cool. They're not that important. But did you know that life on Earth may have been seeded by asteroids? So they might be really important. This comes from these ideas called panspermia. Natural panspermia, artificial panspermia, like in the movie Prometheus, where a planet is seeded for life. But basically, asteroids might be carrying around like amino acids and just other weird things, right, that starts life when they crash into it. And they carry water around, which is also very necessary for, you know, life. You know, we may discover when Elon gets over to Mars that there used to be life there. And what happens if we discover that life was on Mars first, that it's actually older, predates us? Well, some people might suggest then this means that natural panspermia might be correct, where, you know, an asteroid could have hit Mars when life was there earlier than Earth's, and it, you know, transported that life to Earth. You might have heard of water bears, those little, you know, things that can survive any sort of conditions. Not anything, but, you know, like they can survive the vacuum of space for like 30 days. So who knows? Make sure you leave a comment down under. Let me know what you guys want me to watch. Come check out amianterior.com. I'll see you guys next time.